In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we praise and glorify your name. We thank you for the countless blessings that you have bestowed upon us, especially the gift of life. We hope and pray that you send forth your Holy Spirit in each one of us so that we may be enlightened and be guided in everything that we do and in everywhere that we go. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so good evening once again, everyone. Welcome to our last meeting for this semester. This will be our last topic for tonight, which is the continuation of the tourism product discussion. We are now going to talk about the product life cycle, the destination life cycle, so on and so forth. Before that, let me just first share my screen. Sorry. Okay. Okay, so last time we already discussed the half part of my slides in the tourism product, and in our objectives, we already mentioned that at the end of this chapter, you will be able to identify what the tourism product is and its components. You will be able to enumerate the stages of the product life cycle and the destination life cycle. And you'll be able to also recognize that the Philippines has a lot of trustworthy attractions. And lastly, you'll be able to discuss the product development. So as what we discussed in Chapter 1, tourism sells not just one product, but a complete experience. This chapter expounds on what a tourism product is and its components, and the tourism product goes through a variety of stages from development to phase out. Now, we just a recap, no, we also introduced, I also introduced to you last meeting, the five key players in the tourism industry. We have the private and non-profit sectors, public sector services, suppliers, travel intermediaries, and the tourists. So I will not go with this one further since I have already discussed this one. For those who were not able to attend my classes last week, there is a recording available and also the slides are available in our Google Classroom. Okay, moving past that, let us continue with how we define tourism products. So unlike in consumer marketing where we define a product as a thing, a physical object, a service, place, organization, or ideas that is used to satisfy a want or a need. But in tourism marketing or even in the tourism industry, our products are very complex because, again, it's psychological in nature and make up of different components. It's a conglomeration of different products and sectors. They may not be similar to each other, but they contribute and help each other in order for the tourism industry to thrive. So, sagul-sagul siya, no? Yung mga components, ga-comprise yung attractions, facilities, accessibility, image, price. So, kalabanan, no? It's a combination of several things. Ito ang tourism product. When we talk about the product types, we have four types of products, if you can still remember. We have core products, products that the consumer is really buying, facilitating products, so it must be present for the guest to enjoy the core product. You have the supporting products, which is adds value to the core product, added features which helps the core which helps differentiate the core product from its competitors. And the augmented product is what seals the deal. That would mean it would help the consumer decide and consider the product over other products, because this includes accessibility, geographical location, operating hours, atmosphere, customer satisfaction, and etc. Even if your hotel or your tourism product that you offer has a lot of added features or supporting products, but if it does not possess a factor that makes that product ideal, at the same time, pilion jud siya sa consumer, then dira ra pod na mag-lack pod ang imuhang core products dapit, no? The augmented products part. Sorry. Let's now proceed to product considerations, since this could tie up with the augmented products, factors that helps the consumer consider a product. No, parsa nang, yes, daghan ka ikag, meron po nagka nang ga-court ka og person ba? Yes, kaninga person ga-possess siya og daghan kay siyag mga attributes and character, daghan kay siyag achievements. But if wala di it factor sa kaninga person, dili siya pilion jud sa kaning tao nga iyang nagustuhan. So di ba, ana maski kung saan pa nga naani mo tanan, if dili siya ginahan nimo, dili siya ginahan. Ing ana ra pud na siya sa augmented products and also in product consideration. Okay? Even if you have a lot of supporting products, if you do not have an augmented product that makes the consumer choose you, then useless siya po, no? So again, one of those augmented products could be the accessibility, meaning near ang kanisyang tourism product like the hotel to the city center or the ulit sa transportation, it's accessible. So that could also mean, okay, mo po na siya ang reason. Reason nga, no, what do you call this? Pilion siya sa, or i-consider siya ni consumer. So, in availing of tourism products and services, consumers consider several factors. These factors include accessibility, atmosphere, customer interactions with the service system, customer interactions with other customers, and co-production. So, there are several considerations. Accessibility is one thing I consider nga no pilion siya sa pilion siya sa consumer. Atmosphere, customer interaction with the service provider or the staff, customer interaction with other customers, and also co-production of the product or service. These are the things nga i-consider ni tourists for them to choose a certain product. Now that we are done with the recap, let us now proceed to the product life cycle. So in tourism and hospitality, product life cycle can be referred to in two levels. First, a specific product and service on a business or corporate level, such as hotels, restaurants, resort, property, and etc. Second is an aggregate of offerings within a whole destination. So this is what the product life cycle looks like. In general marketing, maopo din siya ang magian sa any kind of product, not just related to tourism. Could even be products nga naa sa grocery store or sa shopping centers. So na magi siya sa introduction. Then growth, maturity, and then decline. So let's start with product development first before we introduce the product to the market. So the product development stage is the very beginning of the product life cycle. It begins with an idea that a new product could possibly satisfy an existing need or want in a specific market. The product idea is further developed through market research and product testing. Okay? So that is product development. Like, you know, I have an idea. I want to develop this kind of product. I want to introduce this product to our customers, So you do product testing, you do further research if feasible ba ni siya, if dawaton ba ni siya sa imong mga consumers. And then we also have the introduction phase, which is the first one sa inyong nakita, no? So bali si product development is the pre kwan pa siya, no? Before mag-start should ang total product development phase, should yung pinakauna. Okay? So the introduction phase is the period wherein the product is introduced to the market. So you've already done your research, you've already picked out the best idea during the development phase. So, decided niyo na i-push through niya siyang kind of product due to successful man ang research ninyo. So, with that, you're going to slowly develop the product and introduce it to the market. It may be a period of rapid or slow sales growth depending on market acceptability of a new product. So, when we talk about introduction phase, this is where you introduce the product hinay-hinay, no? Slowly to the market. It could be through an advertisement, soft launch ninyo, magkatagbog free samples, no? Kay to see if they would really like the product. Well, that's the introduction phase. Hinay-hinay ninyo og introduce ang product to the market. Our market is our potential customers. Next is the growth stage. So, once na slowly introduce na to ang product sa ato ang mga customers, the growth stage is a period of rapid market acceptance and increasing profits. As the product becomes popular with its target market, an increase in sales is projected at this stage. Return on investments will materialize at this stage of the product life cycle. So, anam-anam na siya gina-accept sa inyong mga target market. It has become popular already. And gagrow na ang inyong income. No? Gagrow na ang inyong income, ang inyong revenue by selling this product. So, diri na ni ang return of investment. So, what is your return of investment? Like, for example, you have a capital. Like, nag-prepare ko og at least 150 to 200,000. Na capital, and I am going to use that money to make my product, to advertise it, to sell my product, mag-invest ko on, like, for example, coffee shop, no, or coffee stand. Mag-invest ko on materials, equipment, mag-invest ko on ingredients, and once nga, I have already invested my 200,000 and introduced na ko ako ang coffee to my potential target market, and they will be able to accept it. Inahina na sila mo palit. So, ako ang capital, mabawi na nako siya. Akong 200,000 nga capital or startup nako sa pagsugod o baligya sa product, mabawi nako siya. That's return on investment. And even dili lang mabawi ang 200,000 within a few months, makaginan siya pa kano, mahimo pa siya o 250,000. Next is the maturity stage. Unsa man ni si maturity stage? So, ang growth stage, murag mo man siya katong kanina, mo to siya ang stage class wherein popular kaayo ang product, daghagapalit. So, syempre mabawi jud ni mo imong capital. Nakay return of investment or return on investment. Sa maturity stage is wherein slowly na nag-decline ang imuhang sales, nag-plateau. Di ba siya yung decline siya totally, but I meaning, ni-flatten lang siya. Kay murag napulaan na ang imuhang mga kuan, imuhang mga customer, wala na something new sa imuhang imong gibaligya, no, wala na something exciting nga gi-offer nimo. So the product has achieved acceptance by most of its potential buyers, and you're not accepting any more new buyers. Kaya tungod, syempre, they're not enticed anymore or encouraged because, syempre, kuan na kanang mainstream na imong product, yung itag mainstream kanang murag, di na kayo siyang anak ka popular. Di po yung totally lausulod. Pero, ano siya, no? Medyo, kuan na siya. Medyo, dilin dyan kayo siya yung anak, dyan kahalin nun compare before. Oh, sa so katong hindi kayo hindi, halinon in Bisaya means dili na siya yung anak ka patok, no? Or di na po siya yung anak ka popular when they buy it out. Okay? So, it's also likely that the competition has come in. So, you have a competitor and it attempts to grab the product's market share. And mas daghan na noon ang mupalit sa iyong competitor kay mas exciting and daghan pod og new products gi-offer si competitor compare sa inyo ha. So, to prevent this decline, the company can introduce some innovations. Prevent nga mo decline siya after the maturity stage. They could use market modification. So, the company may introduce innovations to the product in order to attract a related segment of the market and increase consumption further. Okay? So, bago na pod nga features sa product. Okay? Or, could be you could add, for example, yung product kay kuan lang, caffeinated drink. So, mo offer po kag non caffeinated drinks para to attract those who don't drink coffee. Okay, mga non-coffee drinks. Okay, so mo add kag new market. So, before, ang imuha rang ginabaligya nga kape, para rin na sa katong hilig po mga pe. Katong di mo palpitate. But since you realize nga few na lang gapalit sa inyo ha, mag-market modification ka. Mag-add kag similar product, it's still beverages, but the only difference lang is that in the beverages that you sell, it's non-caffeinated, it's non-coffee. That means katong mga dili jud pala kape or mapalpitate sa coffee, they can also buy your product. So nag-add na noon ang imuhang market. And next you have product consumption. So ang product consumption, opening another na pud nga strategy to prevent decline or mulaos imong product. So the company can opt to change the product characteristics such as product quality, features and style to attract new users and to stimulate more usage. Okay? So for example, in product modification, na kay i-add nga breve a bit to or it's like more cream sa imuhang coffee or magbutang baka dira og kanang whipped cream or cinnamon, no, kanang mag-added features lang siya to improve your product, which is something new na pod sa imong mga consumers nga before iced coffee lang ni karon na anay mga different varieties and same ra japon siya nga product iced coffee japon pero gibutangan na nila og kanang like cinnamon or whipped cream or mas gipanindot pa siya nila ang cup or ang packaging. So, yan na, that's product modification. Or you try the marketing mix. So, in marketing, for those who are non-ABM, we have 7 P's of marketing. And in the marketing mix, upatraman na siya, no? Product, price, place, promotion. Gi-add na po na to ang people, physical evidence, and process. So, you could try improving or changing one of the 7 P's of marketing in the marketing mix to prevent consumers from switching brands and to choosing your competitor. This could be an example like ang price niya super mahal, mo lower ka, pero di na siya advisable nga mo lower kag prices as a strategy, not unless if it's really necessary. O, pwede man imong i-change ang location kaysa una layo kay mong location. So na naman siya under placement. So, para near po ang imuhang product sa imong mga consumers. So, you make sure nga near po. Change mo ang placement location sa imong product. Packaging or the way you promote your product. Under man na 7 piece sa marketing mix, no? Ang promotion. So, the way you promote your product, maupod na siya ang imong i-change. Kung makag ka ng unique nga advertisement. Eye-catching. And then, if ever nga dili mo work ang katong mga strategies during the maturity stage, katong marketing mix, product, o market modification, or dili jud ka mo apply ana at all, dira na padulong sa decline stage. So, some successful products stay in the business for a long period of time, but there is also a decline stage. A decline stage is when sales fall off quickly and profits stop. A drop, rather. Meaning, wala na kay wala na kay mo palit, no? Laos na kaayo imong product, gamay na lang kaayo ang imong income. So, once nga fall into a decline, di ka helen na yung product, wala lang kayo mo palit, di pa jud ka mo do something to change the situation of your business, then eventually your product will undergo phase out. Unsa man ni si phase out? So, without a shift in strategy to adapt to the prevailing business environment, phase out may be inevitable. This is the stage when the production of the product or availability of the service will be shut down or deleted from the company product line. Meaning, tangtango na siya, di na siya i-produce, dili na siya ibaligya, pull out na siya tanan, because it will no longer be available because you're not earning money anymore from this product. Okay, that's the phase out part. So, mo to siya ang product life cycle class, no? In general marketing, mo po na ang gina-follow. Now, in tourism, since dili man necessarily tanan na itong products are tangible, naputa ginatawag na itong destination life cycle. And this was developed by Butler in 1980. So, he developed a concept popularly known as a destination life cycle, which uses the product life cycle as its foundation. So, ang basis ni Butler in making a destination life cycle is gikan naman Japan pud sa product life cycle. So, the DLC provides a framework for the marketing and management of destinations as it develops over time. So, there are 6 stages of destination life cycle. So, kung sa product is development, introduction, so si destination life cycle, ang first is exploration. So, this is characterized by a few adventurous tourists, close interaction with locals, minimal effort on social, cultural, and physical environments and local facilities are used. An example of this one is dili pa kayo siya totally gina-explore pa sa mga tourist. Wala, di pa kayo siya ilado, meaning few only knows about this place. It's not yet developed, meaning going there is very hassle. Kay wala pa siya developed roads, wala pa infrastructures nga gi-build. Purely nature itself. Okay? Now, there once nga daghan nagmakabalo, kay naining post ana, there is already na involvement. Characterized by an increase in tourist arrivals, interaction with locals are still high because the locals living in that waterfalls or living in this beach resort, they are the ones who know the place, so they interact with the tourists who are there. Kato mga gapuyo near sa potential tourist attraction. Like sa beaches or sa waterfalls. Some changes in social, cultural, and physical environment infrastructure development begins. So, since kita lang abay-abay naman ang gaagto sa kaninga waterfalls or kaninga beach resort na anay gapasimento sa dalan, kaya para more accessible na siya sa mga tourist, ang uban ga-provide na sila o kanang mga transportation. Okay. So, slow lang ang development, no? Intact raman Japan ang flora and fauna, ang place, as it is, no, naturally. But, nanay mga nadungag like pavements, additional transportation, kung walay hagdanan panaog dito sa waterfall, so like sa Alinsyawan, dito sa San Carlos. So, himuan na siyang hagdanan, kay para safe na sa mga additional tourists nga maabot. Okay, so hinahinay lang, no? Hinahinay nga development. Next, we have development itself. So the tourist arrivals are fast increasing, loss of local control, rise of foreign-owned facilities, migrant laborers, and promotion of artificial attraction. So gadaghan na, no? There is an influx of tourists. There is loss of local control because there are already business owners or investors who are planning to actually go to this place and develop it further, build more buildings, resorts, baron, mga kananan. So, ang mga locals ng Kapuyo, dira, wala na sila control over the place. And, imbis ang mga fishermen, nga taga dira, nga ga-fish sa kana nga beachfront, kay dili na sila allowed, kay gipalit na siya ang dapit ng area, and himuon siya beach resort. Kaya no, wala na yung mga control ang mga locals. And there is promotion already of artificial attraction. What is the promotion of artificial attraction? Artificial attraction are man-made attraction. So, syempre, ang falls, ang beach resort, himuayan na siya ka ng mga accommodation like resorts, other than resorts, kaya ka ng mga facilities pa jud, no? Para sa mga turista, terminal pa ron, or kanang gamay nga pier, no? So, syempre, na yung mga artificial facilities na kaguba sa natural attraction. Next is consolidation. So, tourism has become a major economic factor. There is heavy advertising and promotions. Facilities began to deteriorate as growth rates decline. So, kasi development, daghanag infrastructures na na-built, resorts, sabi, sa kaninga beach. So, na, wala lang dyan na siya, no? Kuan lang, mga huts lang na available, karon na yung mga beach resort, na yung mga hotels na gibuilt, yung mga kananan, mara nagburakay. So, syempre, there's artificial attraction already, and wala na control ang mga locals. Na mabot man dyan na ang time class nga, mapulaan na po ang mga tourists, na muagto po siya decline, kay di na siya as popular as before. At the same time, especially if dili pod ma-upkeep or let's say ma-maintain ang beauty sa beach, no? So, mapo na nga dili na ginahan mo agto ang turista kay mo na dili na manindot ang place, wala na na-maintain, mura jud pa lang makit-an dito. So naanay ma-deteriorate ng mga facilities, growth rate, so few lang ang mga new tourists nga maabot. Kung ito ang uban class, nandiyo na yung mga bagong pakulo, like in, si pangalan ana niya ha, kanang sa Kampestuhan, no, di ba? Ang Kampestuhan, nandiyo na yung bago na po nga sila nga marag attraction nga i-introduce to prevent consolidation, stagnation, nga, kita naman ko dito, kaagto naman mi dito last year. So, ma-retain na siya po nila ang ilang mga previous guests or tourists while being able to attract new tourists pa jud. So now, if ever dili jud mabutang o mga additional nga development sa kanang lugar, ma-fall into stagnation ang destination. So, when the carrying capacity of the destination has been reached or exceeded, it is also characterized by social, environmental, and economic problems. Inflow of tourists comes from the repeat visits and conventions. So, meaning, instead before, nga mudagan nag at least 5,000 ang ilahang mga visitors and more every day or let's say every week, may muna lang siya og 3,000, 2,000, unya ang reason ra nga magbalik-balik ang mga turista dito kay tungod more venue for attending conventions, seminars, diba? So, muna, that's stagnation. Next is decline. So, decline is characterized by a downward rate of tourist arrivals. The decline stage can be mitigated depending on management and marketing efforts to uplift the destination. So, ang decline, no, wala na igaagto. If dili pa rin siya wala pa rin mga marketing efforts in order to uplift or to encourage more tourists, so muna, ma-close na ang destination, dili na siya mabisitaan kaya it's not earning money anymore, laos na, dili na interested ang mga tourists in visiting kaya it stays the same. That's what happened to our People's Park here in San Carlos City before. Wala kayo siya na-maintain sa una, tag-asa kayo mga grass. So nanindot pa kayo na siya kay Najay Pintal, na-close pa dyan ang pool. So dili na kayo tig-agto ang mga tao dito, agto na siya sa mga nang gusto ginahan mag-date-date og tago-tago, no, dito sa People's Park. Paita pod. So, what happened is gihatag pud sa lain nga mo'y mo take charge ana. So gihimuan siya og like kapihan, naapoy kanang other than kapihan, no, gihimuan pud siya og kanang other pud nga attraction like infinity pool, open na pud tong usa ka pool pud sa sulod, and then ilan na pong gi-develop pud further and gi-repaint ang uban nga mga attractions within the park. gimaintain na siya kay para at least o di siya maputin to a decline nga makalimtan na lang siya sa panahon, yung deteriorate na ang state sa mga attractions, walay pintal, no, nangaguba na. So to prevent that, prevent the decline, so dapat i-maintain siya balik, offer something new, provide more marketing efforts to encourage more tourists. So, when rejuvenation and innovations are introduced to the destination, rejuvenation takes place. Unsa man ang rejuvenation? This is what happened to our People's Park and also to Boracay. Although Boracay did not really undergo decline, daghan man japon siyang turista galing due to sustainable reasons raman para dili pud i-rehabilitate lang to si Boracay ino kay daghan namang kaayo og dili na polluted na kaayo siya, kinahanglan jud siya i-maintain, di ba? Pero ang rejuvenation is when padung na decline, like what happened to our park, nga di na kayo siya bisitahon sa mga tao, kaya napulaan na, then di na po kayo ninot ang lugar. So, with that, they developed it, they repainted, they add more features, more attractions, they added like an infinity pool and all, so that it will be rejuvenated, there will be growth. At the same time, it can prevent further decline and eventually mag-phase out. Okay, so we are done with the product life cycle and the destination life cycle. Let us now proceed to the last part of our discussion, and that is the product development. So the product development is an integral part of the success of any business. Competition can come up with new and innovative product that may affect the sales of your existing products. The market always tries to find exciting new products for their changing lifestyle and trends. So, si product development, so this is different from the product life cycle, ha, is the process of how to come up with new products. So, first is idea generation. Siyempre, for you to come up with a new product, it begins with an idea, okay? Idea generation is a systematic way of coming up with new ideas. And sources of new product ideas include external environment, internal sources, customers, competitors, distributors, and other sources. So, again, no? This is where you do brainstorming, you come up with new ideas on what kind of product you will be introducing to the market. Next is the idea screening. Idea generation leaves you with so many ideas that need to be screened. So, di ba, for example, mag-brainstorming mo, you will come up with, let's say, 5 to 10 ideas, and then you realize nga, now, how can we pick the best out of these 5 to 7 ideas? So, you do screening. I-handpick ninyo asa day pinakanindot sa tanan, o sa pa, handpick ninyo sa pinakanindot sa tanan, no? Nga muna ninyo ang i-follow or muna ninyo i-integrate or implement. Next is the concept development and testing. Now that you have already an idea and also chosen the best idea through screening, amo ninyo i-pursue, the products that pass through screening can now be developed further. So, sugda na siya og development. A product concept is developed and tested. The customer should be consulted on which product concepts are actually helpful for them because they are the primary users of the product. So, you include also as co-producers of the product, see? As co-producers of the product, si tourist, okay? Next is the marketing strategy. So, a new product or service is developed to try to gain a marketing edge ad to differentiate itself from its competitors. So, once nga, naghinahinay na mag-develop sa product and you involve the customers in designing the product, i-advertise sa'yo na ninyo. Unsa nga kind of advertisement for us to introduce a product to the market. At the same time, when we introduce it to the market, it should be something that can catch their attention. Next, we have business analysis. So, business analysis stage looks more deeply into how much revenue the product could generate. So, himo kag business plan. Ano sa manta maka-return of investment sa kaninga product? How much revenue will we be able to get from the product? Pila ang atong magasto in making the product? Okay, so kana tanan. Through business analysis. Prototype creation. So now that you have like the business plan, you already have the product in the works already and have an advertisement in mind, how to advertise it and market it. Prototype creation na po ta. So when the concept has been developed, when marketing seems to be feasible, so pagkita niyo sa business plan niyo, okay man siya, and the product will be financially viable, a prototype of the product is created. What is a prototype? A prototype is basically, okay, so the prototype is basically like not the finished product, which you're going to test out if the watan ba ang product or not. Like take for example, you have an invention. For you to actually know if your invention works, you need to build a prototype first, so that in case nga na ay mga mapalya or if there are parts that doesn't work, you can take the prototype back and then develop it further before juni mo siya i-launch as a final product. So, kita po, for example, if you have already designed a product and we know that this product, for example, is dili pa kayo siya perfect, so hatag lang tag mga sample products usa for them to try, testingan lang usa, and if there is something wrong with the product during the testing, then dili pa nato siya ibaligya pa jud. Ato sana siyang i-pull out, i-develop na pod further, i-improve pod further, i-correct ang mistakes before siya ipatest na pod usab for any mistakes. And if successful gani, like okay ang product, wala kay siya mga di kay siya maguba, no, or wala kay siya mga palya, no, how do you call that in Hiligay nun, ha? Pero dili siya, I mean, successful ang product itself in general, wala siya deficiencies and all, wala yung mga damages, then pwede na siya i-reproduce og kadaghan, no, multiply the product further and then sell it to your customers as the final product na jud, or official final product. So next is the test marketing. The product is then launched in a small geographical area to test the components of a marketing mix. There might be a need to adjust any of the marketing mix components before it is launched in a larger scope. Okay, so test marketing lang sa, like, imong prototype successful siya, wala siya mga guba, wala damages, good to go na siya. So imong i-multiply ang product, imbis usara, padaghano na nimo na siya, kay pwede na nimo siya mabaligya. Pwede nimo na siya ma-sell. But you don't want to full blast jud siya nga sell sa tibuok na jud siya nga Philippines or tibuok Negros Occidental. You'll just try to focus selling the product first in your area, sa inyo habang community. Then sa San Carlos City, for example, or in your own city or municipality, or sa moving to Negros Occidental, so itas usa siya sa ginagmay lang nga area, a small geographical area, so that you will be able to know if the waton ba siya sa majority of your customers or not. Then once nga fully accepted naman siya sa San Carlos City or sa municipality where you currently live in, pwede na kakaamat-amat og introduce sa imuhang product to other municipalities, other places pa jud. Pwede magani nationally, like entire Philippines, or internationally. It is expected that the stages of the new product development, if fully observed, can merit market acceptance. Sorry, there are a lot of wrong spelling no sa presentation. Sige lang. And after that you have already commercialized the product, this is when the company will know whether the product has gained market acceptance, hence if the production will be continued or stopped. In evaluation, you will know if the product is successful or not. If it's widely accepted by your consumers, then you continue with the product. If not, then you will have to stop it. No, kay sayang raman sa capital nimo if dili raman siya i-accept sa imuhang market. Okay, so muna na siya, no? Generate ka og new idea. After ma-generate ka new idea, evaluate nimo na siya or do screening. Once makapili na ka out of the 5 or 7 ideas that you have during brainstorming, concept development, so i-develop nimo ang product, then testing, apply marketing strategy, business analysis, and once it is favorable, you proceed with product development. Then test marketing. So i-introduce nimo ang product to a small population lang before nimo siya i-commercialize to a larger population. So here are the checklists to know if kaninga product, sorry, answer the following questions. If imuhang product ba is acceptable and successful to offer in your market. So these are just one of the 17 questions, no? Is the product compatible with the current product line? Do we have the know-how and the appropriate skills? Will it be stable? Will the target market grow? What is the size of the target market? How can we reach the target market? What is the price-value relationship? How far will we fare against competitors? Will there be loyalty impact? How is the product different from other products in the market? What are the copy possibilities? What is the product's market life? How is the product's acceptance? Is marketing made easy? What are the measures of success? And is the capital available? And what are the continuing costs? So, mura na siya mga questions nga imuhang kinahanglan pangutan-on for you to really know if the product is acceptable or not. And if it's feasible, no? And if it's going to be successful. Okay, and that ends my discussion for tonight. Let me just go back to our Google Meet for a while. Okay, so do you have any questions, everyone, before we will end our class for tonight? Igo na ito gihuman siya, no, kay... Mag-exam naman ta next week. Or let me just... Okay. So, if wala na tayo questions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If wala na tayo questions, I will just take the attendance using our automated attendance checker here in Google Meet. I will just send the picture of your attendance after this class. Our exam will be next week, Tuesday. That will be same time, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. And then with regards to our finals exam, so ang coverage na is kanisha, tourism product, and di lang siguro ko mo dwell so much on the economics of tourism and hospitality, but mostly dire ra sa tourism product. Okay? So focus on the new topic that I have discussed to you. Kaning tourism product lang in general. Last week ug karon nga week na discussion. Slides are already uploaded in your Google Classroom. And then types of exam as usual mo ra man japon to. Numeration identification essay. Google form japon mo mag-answer tanan. Same with our prelim and midterms. So if wala na pangutana tanan, let us end our class with a prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, thank you so much, everyone. See you all next week. Usually, din lamang ko ana na mo meet ninyo virtually. If kaya raman ninyo, no, but sige lang, I will just message you and also do a follow-up with your instructions sa finals exam. Thank you so much, everyone. Advance Merry Christmas to all and good evening. Bye, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Goodbye.